33 just feels even more intentional, even more amazing, even more abundant. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Yeah. Welcome back to another YouTube, y'all. It is your girl's birthday. Right now it's officially 3:45 in the morning. It is so early, but I'm getting ready to do a balloon ride across the pyramids. I think it's called like teotihuacan, something like that. So I have to go hurry up and get ready, and then I'm gonna come back and chat with you guys all about my birthday plans. So yeah. Let's get it. Okay, so I'm just wearing a white shirt with my favorite Twiley leggings. Y'all, I love these leggings so bad. And this is my birthday hair. Looks so, so, so cute. But I'm trying to decide right now. I'm wearing like beige and denim. I'm trying to decide if I want to do like these. Oh, these are really cute. I'm thinking about the duties because it's giving like early 2000 vibes, or these. Hold on. Or these. Oh, these are so cute too. These are so, so cute. And I feel like these match the hot air balloon a little bit better. I don't know. It's giving bring both, switch him up. But hold on, y'all. Let me put y'all down. Okay, so I'm about to just quickly pack me some fruit on the ride to go. I do not like to rush. That is not in my ministry, rushing at all. I don't like it. Real quick, I want to talk to you guys about my birthday. So my official birthday is tomorrow, period. It is tomorrow. And today what I'm gonna do is a hot air balloon over teotihuacan. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. And then spend the rest of the day just like relaxing, chilling with Benj. At first I was gonna get a babysitter, but I was like, nah, I'll just hang out with my child. I'll just do that. And then what I'm gonna do is Tuesday is my official birthday. Tomorrow is my official birthday. So tomorrow what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to a spa and do like a deep tissue hot stone massage. And then tomorrow I'm gonna go to Kuyakon with my friend Jake. I'm so excited. No, sorry, not tomorrow, on Wednesday. Wednesday I'm gonna go to Kuyakon with my friend Jake. We're gonna take the train there and then take an Uber back. And then on Thursday, I'm gonna take a crocheting class. Another thing is too, hold on, let me get y'all right. Y'all, I don't know. I really don't know if it's just me. I just did a video on this, but I don't know what's going on with me. But I bought this $500 dress from House of CV, and I just was feeling like, what am I doing? Like the dress was beautiful and everything like that, but I realized like I don't love getting dressed up, I do love wearing really expensive clothes. Hold on. When I can, I do love it. But I don't love dressing up and just taking pictures and going out to eat and talking over loud music anymore. I don't know what it is, but that's just not my ministry anymore. In my 20s, yeah. In my 20s, no problem. But now I'm just like, I don't know, I'm craving experiences. Something about turning 33 is telling me, girl, be more intentional with your time, with your energy, with your community, with your friends, with who you communicating with the things you do, and create moments. Create moments versus like getting dressed up, taking pictures, posting them. Like I had to really ask myself, what am I doing this for? When I think about shoes and bag and hair and makeup and nails, and I'm like, I don't know. And I definitely think moving abroad has changed the way I see things, and it's definitely changed the things that I require to be happy, and it's most importantly changing me. Like, it's just evolving me. So I don't know, y'all. I don't know if it's because I'm healing or I'm evolving or I'm getting older or I'll move to Mexico, but the things that I require to feel good are just shifting, and that looks like just having more experiences. So I'd rather do things like the hot air balloon ride, the spa, and then afterwards I'm gonna do a vision board party. I forgot to tell you that I'm gonna do a vision board party tomorrow for my birthday. I did end up getting the Harper's Bazaar cover with Salon, but I'm not gonna cut that one up. But today I'm gonna go get some magazines so I can really. I got the board. Let me show you the board that I got. I got the board. Yes, I got the board. so I'm really excited about that. So I'm definitely doing a solo dolo vision board party. Might buy wine, might not, because that's not even my thing anyway, like that. Like, I don't like to drink. I feel like every year when it's your birthday, it's your new year. So I just want to set the tone for like how I want my new year to feel. What kind of friends do I want to have? What more of community I want to have? How can I get more intentional with that? How do I want to take care of myself? What does my ideal morning and nighttime routine look like? What hobbies do I want to pick up? How do I want to spend more time in nature? Just new things that I want to learn, new books that I want to learn, quotes that I want to live by this year. All of that in the vision board. So I'm doing a vision board party for my birthday, and I feel like that's the perfect way to honor myself. Not too much. I don't know what it is, but this season I'm really craving solitude and just craving more intention. That's it. I'm just craving more attention. So I don't know, can y'all relate to this? But just things are changing. Like, I feel like as you get older, the things that you just want change. And I think that that's okay. That's totally okay. Okay, so I'm about to get ready to walk my dog and then catch a cab to the meetup point because we are about to do the hike. Okay. All right, y'all, see you in a second. Okay. Hi, Dory. Hi. What's up with my Yuda? You gonna miss me today? Mommy gonna see the hot air balloon. It's mommy's birthday. Come, Papa, come. Oh, you're so sweet. You're so okay. I feel enough. I feel the birthday love. I feel it, Papa. Thank you so much. Okay, Papa, so we're gonna take you on a quick 15-minute walk. It's gonna be real quick. All right, y'all, let's go. I love we are me, everybody I drove with. It is so cold. Like, I had to put my vape on. It's really, really cold. But the coffee is heating up and so is the tea. So yeah, I'm trying to think, do I want some drone footage? Look at the way the drone footage looks. It looks, oh, I'm drooling. Look at the way the drone footage looks. It looks so cool. Oh, it looks really, really cool. If y'all ever do this, y'all definitely need to bring y'all coat. Hold on, they over there making marshmallows. I want parts. Oh, look at this. Gracias. Oh,
it's...
Oh, esta es mejor? Sí, 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 sí. Oh, es muy frío. Se frío. It's actually like really cold, but this is, it feels really good right here.
Ya está el café si quieres.
Sí, listo. Gracias. ¿Cómo se dice?
Bombón.
¿Cómo?
Bombón.
Bombón. No está. Sí, es. Esta. Marshmallow. Pocheta.
Brocheta.
Rocheta.
Bro.
Porro.
Brocheta.
Porrocheta. Gracias.
No, a ti. Lo conocemos como un bombón quemado.
¿Mm?
Bombón quemado. Así.
It's
kind of
high.
We're moving. What's going on? What's going on? Oh my God. so scared. We bending, we bending.
Not bad.
Not bad. Oh, we going back up though. Oh, hold on, hold on.
What? Okay.
Yeah, they did good.
This toast, there's a tradition of making a toast after we land for several reasons. The first one is to celebrate that everything went well. At the end, we are in a different means that is not ours, so it seems that we could fly, pass over the pyramids, and land safely is the first thing. What do you think?
Yeah, it was amazing. Yeah.
Two.
Gracias. Okay, so we about to taste it, see what it's hitting foul. Oh, she's a good girl. Oh, she's nice and sweet. I like her. Hold on. Yeah, she's good. She's good. I do need something to eat though, but she's good. Look at that, y'all. Got my certificate for flying. Y'all already know one thing about me. The majority of the plate gonna be green. So I got some ensalada, some espinaca, I got like eggs, and then like some pico de gallo. This looks like sauteed chicken with peppers and a little bit of hot sauce. Then some natural orange juice, some, yeah, I'm excited. So I'm only in a group of three, but right after we eat, we are going to like this archaeological site. I low-key don't want to go. I don't want to go, but I don't think it's going to be that long. The dressing is really good. The dressing is really, really good. The eggs are good. I thought it was gonna be like food in a cave. This is way better than food in a cave. Let's taste the pico de gallo. I really want to put pico de gallo in a bag. Every time I'm in a restaurant, I just want to put it in a bag. So good. It's so good. I feel like, excuse me, I feel like going upstairs just to get more pico de gallo. And that sauce is a little spicy, but I'm not mad. The chicken is unflavored, unseasoned. But with the sauces and the pico de gallo, it's all right. But since I've gotten braces, I do need to brush my teeth after every time I eat. All right, y'all, I'm gonna enjoy this and hit y'all in a second.
Okay, this agave, here in Mexico, we call maguey. This is maguey. This maguey is the same family aloe vera.
Sí. Okay?
When this maguey is about 10 or 12 years old, we cut the heart. Later, this plant in the center produces a juice. The name of the juice is honey water.
Oh, honey water.
Yes, ma'am. The honey water, the color is amber color, transparent. Mm-hmm. And the honey water is medicine, is good for stomach, and especially is good for ulcers. Okay? Mm. The natural stone, authentic. Look at this one. Sí, ahí están las piedritas.
Oh, wow.
Amigos, this stone we consider the symbol or the amulet for the peace in the family. Uh-huh, this one.
We're about to try the honey water. Oh, I thought you said it's brown.
No, this is, this is like a milk. A ver, amor.
Gracias.
1 second, don't drink. Bueno, chicos, vamos a probar.
So,
sí, mi amor.
Salud.
A ver,
salud.
Chicos, salud. Les van a colocar una stick. Ajá. Eso es para la bienvenida de ustedes a este lugar. Bueno, chicos, salud.
Salud. Let's try it.
¿Es fuerte?
No es fuerte de alcohol, pero es sabor, tiene un sabor particular.
Oh, no fuerte. It wasn't strong to me.
Sí, claro.
Es muy parecida.
Tiene la humedad.
Es muy parecida. ¿Por qué? A ver, ¿por qué? Platíquenme. ¿Qué pasó?
No, yo y el mezcal no somos muy buenos amigos.
¿Oh, sí?
El que sigue, sí, pero con el mezcal no somos muy
buenos. 1 second. Look at this one. This is a mezcal and look at the worm.
Oh, is that real?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Oh.
Ahora, chicos, vamos a probar esto con un poquito de sal.
That was a worm.
When you drink the mezcal, I recommend you mix with salt and chile. But first is salt. Second, the shots of the mezcal. And later, when you drink, you exhale like a dragon.
Like.
Okay. Now, exhala, mami. Eso. Checa el sabor. Es ahumado. Como a madera quemada. It's smoky. Ya. Ahora vamos a probar este papi.
It is smoky.
Ya.
It tastes interesting.
Esta es una crepita.
The salt was good.
This is a similar.
I like the salt.
Yeah. It has chile and salt.
Oh. Ajá, chile, sal, and the worm too.
Okay.
This is a cream. And this cream, this is made with a mezcal. And the cream is with a, it's not cream, it's almond milk.
Okay. Oh, it's almond
milk. Almond milk, and the flavor is pistachio, okay?
Oh, pistachio.
Salud.
Salud. That's actually really good. Similar to Bailey's.
Yeah, it's similar to Bailey's, but the Bailey's is made with a whiskey.
Oh, this is mezcal. I feel a little. We keep our cups. Keep. Basura.
Ahorita dámelo. The other liquor is cacao and pineapple and the.
Okay.
My beautiful group. Let me show you. Collection and collection. These are by handwork and these are the replicas, the accordion of the anthropology museum.
Okay.
The symbol of the prosperity. This is a beautiful ceremonial mask. And this is the symbol of the abundance. Here in Mexico we call choconostle.
Choconostle.
Choconostle is the popular name. Because tuna, the prickly pear, the fruit is very, very sweet. Okay. It's a similar kiwi, yeah. Okay? And this, no, this is a similar a lemon. Now, you say everybody, arriba.
Arriba.
Abajo.
Abajo.
Al centro.
Al centro.
Y adentro.
Y adentro.
Delicioso.
It tastes medicinal.
Yeah.
It tastes very medicinal. It tastes like cough syrup.
Okay. Now, amigos, vamos a decir un refrán mexicano.
Mexicano.
Estiro el brazo.
Estira el brazo.
Encojo el codo.
Encojo.
El codo. This is codo.
Corro.
El codo. Y este traguito.
Y este catrito.
Traguito.
Traguito.
Me lo chingo todo.
Me lo chingo todo. Oh, mi favorita.
Está. No, sí. This is your favorite for you. This one.
That one?
Sí.
We haven't tried that one.
Sí.
Oh, it's mejor.
Remember, it's the number six.
Number six.
No, here, the stick.
Six.
Oh, sorry. Al centro.
Al centro.
Un movimiento sexy. Movimiento
CR.
Es el
mejor
de este.
¿No te gusta?
Oh.
Pero si te la
abrochas,
te la.
She's a cute girl.
Yeah.
She's really good.
It's cacao.
That was good.
And here we have the flavors: pistacho, marzapan, pineapple, cacao, and the cactus fruit,
is
this one, in a small size.
Okay.
My beautiful group, gracias.
Oh,
that's all my explanation.
Oh.
Thanks for your very nice attention. Look around. You pay only the price market here, acá. But
sí.
No
7%
more tax. No,
sí.
No.
Oh, that's muy bien. Look at this. 510 pesos. This was the best one to me. She was right. This one was definitely the best one. My dad loves chess so much. Like, he taught me how to play. Oh, you can't move these. Oh, that makes sense. Any movies? Oh, yes! Oh my god, I totally want a chessboard. This is so nice. Okay, so the next part of the tour is we just get to walk around this archaeological site. I hope I'm saying that right. And it's really nice. I probably could have taken this jacket off, but there are the pyramids. They're kind of nice. They look really beautiful. I'm gonna show y'all when I get a little closer, but look at this. This is what we saw when we were on the balloon. Looks pretty cool up close. Y'all, look. Oh my god. I gotta be careful. Okay. Look at this. Wow, all this is so cool. I ever go to certain places or have certain experiences. I do this a lot when I'm traveling solo, but I'll have an experience and I'm just like, oh my god, I just know this person would love this. Oh, so nice. This kind of reminds me of Peru. I think I'm gonna do one little loop, go derecho, and then go izquierda. Wow, y'all, look at this. She is huge in person. Oh my god. Okay, I ended up getting closer. It's so big. Wow. Y'all, I had to change my glasses, and these are actually really cute. But I had to change them because I was like squinting and stuff. But these are a lot better. What's an icon in here? But I wanted to show y'all these stairs. Look at this. Look at this. So freaking cool, right? Like, it just feels ancient. This is Mesoamerica though, but yes, feels pretty good. I'm about to start walking back because I'm pretty tired. Oh, black girls.
Pretty girls involved with me, making pretty love to me, pretty. Pity, pity.
Okay, and we are back home. So excited. I miss my dog so much. But before I came home, I stopped at the supermarket. I usually like to get most of my fruits and veggies from the Mercado, but there's this one supermarket that I love to get my meats from, my rice, my pasta from. So that's the one for me. So I was like, let me stop there real quick. So let me show y'all what I got. Oh, I just like to organize my veggies like this because potatoes belong in a cool, dry area, and that's over here. I don't get any sunlight over here, so it's perfect. The ginger and turmeric live right here, and this is just where I keep my rings. I made some tea for myself. I really want to drink some tea. Okay, so let me show y'all what I got. I got some bread, multi-grain bread. It got 12 different grains in it. Love that. We got some ensalada. We got oatmeal with nueces, pasas, and dátiles, which is like nuts, walnuts, and dates. I got some oatmeal bars. This is for like when I'm running to Pilates. And I got some tuna fish with... Wait, can y'all see that? Okay, and then I got some tuna fish with water. I got some Alfredo sauce. I don't really like Prego, but this was the only tomato sauce they had, so we gonna see what that's hitting for. I got some mantequilla de mani, which is peanut butter. I got some mouthwash and then some pasta. I got a ton of meat for Papa, cause he's just been raw dogging it with me, just straight dry food. So I got him a few things of meat. This is for the spaghetti that I'm gonna make. I got some arroz. Wait. And yeah, I think this is it. Not that many things, but this all came up to $60, which I thought was a little pricey, but I was like, I won't be going there for a while. I go there once a month, so this is stuff that I kind of just need. So yeah, this is an investment. She's an investment. So that's all the stuff I got at the market. Right now I need to book my spa appointment for tomorrow morning. I'm like waiting to the last minute because I'm asking everybody. I'm trying to get reviews. I'm watching TikToks. I'm like, I'm trying. But I think I found the dream spa that I'm gonna go to tomorrow morning. So I need to book that, edit some videos, do my crochet. So your girl will holla at y'all tomorrow. And tomorrow's my birthday. Okay. So I'll see y'all later. Bye. Hey y'all, it is officially my birthday. I'm so excited. But I wanted to show y'all what I'm wearing really quickly before I head out to the spa. I wanted to wear something cute, cozy, you know, nothing too crazy, something real like comfy. So yes, hi Papa. Hi Papa, it's mommy's birthday. He's like, girl. But yes, okay y'all, I'm about to head out to the spa and then I'm going out to eat and then I'm gonna do my vision board. It's gonna be good day. Oh, look at this. So beautiful. So beautiful. Come, Papa. Okay. Y'all, look at this massage room. Oh my God, it's so beautiful. Then they got the tables here. And then look at this. Oh my God. First of all, I got me the little robe on. Period. Oh, the music is relaxing. And then look at this. Got the thermal tub right here. Oh my God. I'm so excited. Okay. Relax, girl. Relax. Act like you been so nice. Okay, relax. Cause I do this. But yeah, y'all. Let me go enjoy this walk. Okay, and then they got me in a sauna. They told me to come into the sauna for 10 minutes, so I'm gonna do that. It's a bit hot in here, so I'm gonna take my camera out. But yeah, y'all, and then look on the outside. There's more little pools over there. In the steam room. Oh my God, I was in there butt naked just now, y'all, butt naked. And they gave me some mineral water, which is so nice. So y'all, hold on, I wanna see what these two. Oh my God, this is so freaking. I'm probably gonna sit here and read. Oh my God, yes. Okay, y'all, now they said that I need to sit in here for 20 minutes. So let's do that. Let's do that right now. I don't know if I can record because I do want to be a little bit more present, but we're gonna see y'all. We're gonna see.
Are you studying?
Oh, that's the perfect.
Good. That was the best massage I've ever had in my life. This whole experience was the best spa, wellness spa experience I've ever had in my life. You see, even the tone is different. Even the tone, the temperament is different. Everything is muy tranquilo, like paz. Like I am just so like at peace and a lot of tranquility. Okay, so I'm about to head out now. I'm about to go to the cafeteria and get some food. Let's see what they got for food.
Y'all, oh my God. Let me just show you the outside real quick. Look at this. It looks like a greenhouse moment. Like I just want to hang out here and chill. Just look. Oh, so beautiful. And they have like salmon salads, chicken salad.
I've decided to get a smoothie because I just want something a bit more refreshing and light. This ice is perfect. Yeah, I forgot my jewelry in my robe, so they're gonna go get it for me really quickly. I ordered this smoothie with like mango, dates, avena, which is oatmeal. Good stuff. Muchas gracias.
Un placer.
Sí. Buen día. Igualmente. I feel like the whole time when I was getting a massage and I was in a bath, I just kept thinking like, What if I became the Keith Lee of like wellness experiences? Like rating different spas, different body treatments, different like skin treatments, just different healthy food restaurants. Just going to different most popular restaurants and ordering healthy things. So when you do go out to eat when you're traveling, you're not just always eating fries and wings and burgers and just poor quality foods. Instead, while on vacation, you're still eating super, super delicious and you're still keeping up with your diet and your wellness goals. This way you don't gotta restart when you go back home. I was thinking about that the whole time, like what if I did something like that? So, I don't know, what do y'all think?
What do y'all think about that?
Hold on y'all, my smoothie just came and it is so good. Oh my God, let me just show y'all real quick. Ah, oh, look at that, it is so freaking good. It's so, so, so good. So, oh my God, I could taste the mango, the orange juice, the pomegranate, the cacao, the almonds. Oh. This whole experience was definitely like a 9.5, 9.6 out of 10. It was truly a wonderful experience. Plus, I really enjoyed that I was by here by myself most of the day. Like, actually, every room I was by myself. So it's like renting out an entire sanctuary for yourself. So this is perfect. I don't know what it looks like on the weekends, but I think moving forward, I'm always gonna come here on like a Tuesday. So yeah, that's what we're doing moving forward. That is what we're doing, because this was so good. This is hands down the best birthday ever. No funny. But okay, y'all, I am about to read my book. I'm reading The Afro Minimalist, A Guide to Living with Less. This feels so fitting for where I am in life right now, because I really do feel like my life has been so much more with less, and I don't need as many things. I don't need to consume as many things. Like, I'm feeling a lot more fulfilled and purposeful and just like happy. So this just felt like the perfect time to read this, because I do want to stay in tune with living and having less. So the back of the book says, forget the aesthetics of mainstream minimalism and discover a life of authenticity and intention. Yeah, you got me. You got me. It says, this is a testament to the idea that anyone can be a minimalist and a warm invitation to a life curated with intention. Oh, I love that. I love that. So definitely gonna tune into this book, read it, and I will hit you guys in a second. Wait. So they just gave me some like ice cream. It's called Zapote, which she said is like the sweetest fruit in Mexico. And then some Greek yogurt. So I'm gonna try it. I've never had dark ice cream before, so we're gonna see. Oh, it's sweet. It kinda reminds me a little bit of strawberry ice cream. Yeah, it reminds me of strawberry ice cream. It tastes like it needs a banana. It's good. But maybe not for me. But good. And definitely refreshing. But okay, y'all, I'm about to read my book. I'll be back. So now I'm officially at PF Chang's. Apparently my friend Jake told me that these are in Estados Unidos, like they're in the States. I didn't know that. So I ordered me this spicy shrimp tempura and this like chicken saute dish. They have this honey chicken, but I don't really like when meat is sweet. So I ordered this like spicy type of chicken with vegetables and white rice. And I ordered a drink too. To know me, it's not, I don't really drink like that, but I'm like, it's my birthday, why not? But y'all, let me run it back real quick. When I tell y'all the spa was a top tier experience, I am going to find a way to put that in my monthly budget, no matter what, like a monthly massage, because the way she was just rolling out certain parts of my body, like I work out a lot. I walk my dog a lot. My ankles feel loose, my neck feels loose. Like, I felt like I was floating afterwards. Like, it's just, it's so good. Like, I need to make that more of a monthly routine, maybe even like bi-weekly down the line. But I gotta get monthly massages. It's an absolute must. I'm gonna figure out a way. I even asked them for packages. I was like, do y'all got any packages? They was like, oh, we gonna work on that for you. I'm like, that's so sweet. They give you tea, they give you water. Just the entire experience was amazing. And the second you walk in, everything just smells so good and so serene. And the colors were like stone and black and cream and brown and very neutral and relaxing colors. And also, the fact that they had the thermal bath in the room, top tier experience. Like, I low-key never want to get in a thermal bath with multiple people again. Like, I'm gold. I don't want that for me. Like, no. Oh, look at the rings, y'all. I'm excited. I got them from H&M. But yes, and the fact that I was the only one in the spa the whole entire day, I love that. I feel like that is serendipity. That was the universe and God, like, here, happy birthday. You get to spend time by yourself. We know that you're in another country by yourself. We know that you was really scared and anxious about spending your birthday by yourself, but you decided to take care of yourself, so let me take care of you. That's what I think happened. So I am about to eat. This guy smiling at me. I'll smile at you too. What up? I will smile at you too. Oh my God, that looks so good. I should not say ragu, but that looks so good. It looks like this sushi roll. It looks really good. I might order a sushi roll as well, but I don't even eat that much. Oh, I think this is my drink. Gracias. This is my drink. So this is a whiskey with agave, piña, and mango. So I'm excited. I told y'all before, I really don't drink like that. Well, but when I do drink, I love the way a drink looks, but I never really like juice, if that makes sense. Like, juice and liquor, I feel like my body be like, chill, boy. Just liquor is like, alright. This is so good. I take back what I just said. Oh, this is so good. Oh, this is so good. This is honestly the best birthday I've ever had in my life. The best birthday, from being on a hot air balloon to going to the spa to eating out by myself at a really beautiful restaurant. Let me show y'all this restaurant. Like, how cute is this? Like, and I feel like I'm wearing black. I'm wearing like the perfect type of vibe for this. Everything was just so amazing and so intentional. It just feels like it was designed for me. Everybody keeps smiling at me because I got this camera on. And then I'm about to make a vision board. I'll get some magazines, make a vision board, and chill. That is my dream, and chill. And I think I'm gonna end this vlog tonight, unfortunately, but there's another video that I wanna do for you guys, which is like the top 33 things that changed my life in honor of my birthday. Yeah, I wanna do that. And tomorrow is Kuyakon, so I just feel like it's just gonna be too much on one vlog. So yeah, y'all, we about to eat this full. I'm so excited. I just love that my nails is like natural looking. I just can't explain it, but everything feels right. I feel like I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be, and I feel like things are only gonna get better. 33 just feels even more intentional, even more amazing, even more abundant. Like, let's go. Okay, y'all, the food is here. Oh my God, look how good that looks. Oh, I hope it's spicy. And then we got the shrimp. Oh my God, it's so good. I just know that sauce is gonna be so good. And then there's the rice. I definitely think I'm gonna need a little bit more rice, but yes! Let's see. That's really good, but it's not hot. Oh, it's warm. It's cold to warm. I love you, my food hot. Let's try this though. Hola, trabaja aquí?
Sí.
Sí, es posible caliente, es frío.
Sin problema, sí. Caliente.
Gracias, es uno más caliente.
No se preocupe.
Gracias. This is so good. I'm hyped you're gonna eat the lettuce wrap too. Muchas gracias.
¿Más caliente?
Sí.
¿Tibio?
Sí, gracias. Es hot. Gracias.
Un gusto.
Food hits different when it's hot. I'm gonna enjoy this. I'll hit y'all right back. Okay, y'all, so we just left P.F. Chang's. It was so, so, so good. But now I remember why I don't eat and drink at the same time. It just makes you feel funny. Like, it's not a good feeling. I feel like it's either you drink it or you eat it. Both just feels like a bad combination. Like, I don't know. I don't know. I don't love it. They have a Zara. They have a Bershka. They have so many things. Okay, okay, I found it. I found it. It's called San Borna. San Bornas. Yeah, this is it. Okay, they got a selection going on. They have Vogue. Okay, Coco. Y'all see that? $195? Yo, that's expensive. That's a lot of money. I got this one already, but I don't think I'm gonna cut into her. I'm looking for like AD. Like, where's the AD book? So help me decide, right? Because it's between these four magazines. I don't want to spend over $30 on them, if I'm being honest. But let me show y'all, right? So they got L with Naomi for Mexico. This is 55 pesos, so it's not so bad. Then they have Angel Reese. Oh, this one is a little expensive, but I feel like she's that girl, like she's worth it. Then they have Coco. I don't know much about Coco, but I do remember like, she had a low tolerance for the bullshit, like, and I like that, I support that. And between these two, I think I'm definitely gonna choose this one because this one is $2.95 and this one has like really pretty pictures in it as well. It's called Aviantes, which I don't know what that means, but it's giving interior design for sure. So it's giving $40, but these are all perfect. All right, I'm gonna do it. So I got everything. I'm excited about it. My apartment doesn't give black girl, and I want the magazines in my crib to give it a little bit, just a little bit. So yeah, I ended up getting all the black girl ones. Yeah, I'm really hyped about that. So I got home and realized I am very, very, very tired. This is why I don't drink. This is why I do not drink. Like, you catch me having a drink maybe twice a year. Like, I never ever drink, and that's because it makes me tired. But to be honest, every time I drink, I do get really, really happy. I'm not one of those people that drink and I just be sad, or like, I just get extra happy. Like, I wanna dance and I wanna talk a lot and I laugh a lot. So I don't know, I don't know. But I say this to say, like, I'm really tired, and because it's my birthday, I'm gonna rest. I'm gonna rest, I'm gonna honor rest right now. So I'm making me some tea, some vanilla caramel black tea. I'm just chilling. Edit a video, maybe, maybe not. Lately, I've been watching Grey's Anatomy, which is like really, 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 really good. Y'all, it's so good. It's so good. They did not have to do that to Lexi or Sloan. They didn't have to do that. No funny, they have to do that, because I thought when O'Malley happened, I thought I was in shreds then. Like, I thought I was in pieces then. But Lexi? Why? Just why? Like, just corny, corny, corny. Didn't love that, didn't love that. But okay, 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 back to what we was talking about. I am not gonna do the vision board today. It's given, that's gonna be another day. I don't have scissors and glue as well, so I just feel like that should just be parked for another time. But I did wanna share something with y'all, right? So I went on Twitter and I tweeted, it's my birthday, can y'all tell me one thing I ever posted that made you feel better? And the comments are so sweet. So I wanted to read some of them to y'all. So one comment said, every time you post a grocery haul or something that makes you excited and gives you joy, I get my life too. I love that. I love that, because sometimes I'm like, oh my God, I'm always posting this food, but it's how I eat and it's how I live, and I want to encourage more people to eat better and live better as well. Then somebody said, you upgrading your life is one of the best things I've seen on the TL. It gives me so much inspiration. Knowledge on gut health has saved me. Happy birthday. Your first viral Trader Joe's haul had me smiling and wanting to buy more produce. Period. 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 Because when we eat colorful, we feel colorful. I said, eat colorful, feel colorful. Feel colorful. No, legit though, legit. And somebody else said, those turmeric ginger shots and probiotic recommendations were life changing. Period, they really are. If you want to heal your gut, definitely go watch those videos. Like, it really makes a difference. And definitely sign up for the Holistic Homies membership. It's $5 a month where we talk about recipes, weekly wellness, blogs. It's a nice little vibe and a community over there. So highly recommend, $5 a month. Somebody else said, your Mexico journey gives me so much hope and inspires me to take big risks. Period, big risk, big reward. I know we hear that all the time, but sometimes we need to take a leap or like step off the ledge to learn how to fly. For real, like, your girl is flying now. Flying! That's, it's like really nice. Somebody said, literally every post, you're always authentic. You being you is the influence. You influenced me to just look on the brighter side of things. This this is really nice, y'all. This is really nice. So I said I was a part of your book club, and the way you reminded me to nurture my inner child was a big part of my healing. For those who know, I did the book club, The Artist Way by Julia Cameron, and that was really good. Watch some of my old YouTube videos. Some of the sessions are up there. Somebody else said, yeah, ginger shots. I made them, and it felt so good. Your energy is inspiring, but difficult to match because all of the shitty things going on in the world. But you're an example of what faith and happiness reflects. Somebody else said, I remember you mentioning EFT tapping and recommended Brad Yates. I'm grateful for that because I haven't tapped in a while. And somebody else said, you posted a salad one time that caused me to follow you because I'm seriously being intentional with this plant-based lifestyle. But your personality was a beautiful thing. Happy blessed to be alive day. Great things in the earth. Y'all, you know why that's also so beautiful? Because I really got dragged. I think it was October 1st or October 3rd. I got dragged so bad for eating a salad. Like, if you saw it, you saw it, but if you didn't, great. But it hit 45 million views, and I was just really, really, really sad about it. So many people was coming at me like, oh my God, like, who smiles at a salad? Oh, laughing my ass off salad, or no salad is that good, or her salad is mad dry. Like, the way the internet was really dragging me, and I literally love salad. I literally love salad. I literally have a salad every day. Every day, like, I need the crunch, I need the water, I need the green. I love the way it tastes, tomatoes, peppers, onions, with the cucumbers and the shredded carrots, with the Caesar dressing on it. You could throw shrimp in it, chicken, salmon. Like, a salad go crazy. Crazy. You add some fries to it, it goes crazy. I love salad. And one thing I will say, I used to not like salad. When I was in high school, I didn't like salad. Even when I was in college, I did not like salad. It took me modeling and passing out and being malnourished to step into a healthier lifestyle. And the moment I started doing that, I started paying attention to foods that give me energy, foods that don't give me energy. And then after that, I started really focusing on gut health, studying gut health, working with holistic gastro doctors, really taking it seriously. Is reading non-stop gut health books. I read a lot, and the more information I got around diet and mental health, I started peeping game, like how we eat, how we feel, how we think. All is related. So I really do enjoy eating. And when I was younger, I never used to crave salads, and now I crave salad. One thing the body gonna do is crave what it's most familiar with. So when you change what you're most familiar with, you change like how you eat. You eat more greens, you eat more colorful, you add greens to every single meal. You meal think, you make sure you're thinking about your meals before you get hungry, because by then it's too late. Like, when you start doing those things, it literally changes your relationship with food, which changes your relationship with yourself, with time, with energy, with money. Everything, literally, you rush less. Everything starts to excel when you change your diet. Everything, your whole life gets better when you change your diet for the better. Everything, the way you see things, the way you interpret things, the way you experience things, like, everything hit different. So that's all I'm saying is, like, I really do enjoy salads. Like, and I want everybody else to enjoy eating good too. Eating good don't gotta be a drag. Like, you don't go, oh, I gotta eat a salad. No, what you like to eat? Let's add greens to it. What's your favorite food? Let's add greens to it. There's always a way to make your favorite food a little bit healthier, and I want to encourage people to step into that. That's all. That's all. That's it. My bad. That's it. So yeah, that was really nice that, like, they came from that and then they stayed. Somebody else reposted some of my tweets, and one of the tweets was, people can only meet you as far as where they're at. It doesn't serve you to get upset or disappointed. It's just who they are. Move accordingly, even if it means loving from a distance. I said that in 2021, June 23rd, 2021. That's really beautiful. Your turmeric and ginger shot videos gave me life and helped me get through some of the most toughest periods of my life. The amount of enthusiasm, wisdom, and personality was just lovely to watch. Thank you. Still make it to this day. Oh, that was really nice. Oh, don't cry on camera. Oh, that was so nice. You telling us we can restart our life and pull up to the potential at any age. Be gracious with yourself because more things are intended for you. Okay. That's really nice. Okay, do y'all want to answer that? If you've been following me for a while, you just started watching my YouTube, what's one thing I ever said that made you smile, inspired you, wanted you to step into a healthier version of yourself, picked up a new habit, learned something new? What's something? Tell me, what's something? Oh, Oh my god, your account is a timeline cleanse. Okay, I'm gonna stop because I'm gonna start really crying on here. Somebody, oh, this is the last one. Somebody said, I love when you randomly ask us questions about our health and wellness. I appreciate a good prompt that causes me to look inward and encourages personal growth. Oh, okay, y'all. We're gonna end this vlog. Big love, not the little one, y'all. I am so grateful for y'all. Thank you for tuning in with this. I am just feeling so grateful, so abundant. Muy agradecida. Like, I hope I said that right, because that's my favorite word in Spanish. It means very grateful. And y'all, like, I'm just so grateful. Like, I don't even know another word. I just feel like extremely, extremely full. My cup is so full, and I just cannot be more appreciative of that. I feel like I'm in a new era of taking responsibility of my joy, my happiness, my mood, my energy, my success, my money, my love, my body, my mental thoughts, everything, my morning routine, like everything is lining up for me in the best way because I am showing up in the best ways. And on the days that I'm not showing up in the best ways, I give myself grace for the days that I'm showing up for the best way, if that makes sense. So I'm just big grateful, not the little one. So yeah, y'all, I'm gonna end out this vloggy vlog, but please like, share, comment, subscribe, tell a friend to tell a friend, share the wealth, all that. And I will talk to y'all in the next one. Later.